my channel Crochet Skills. In today's video you will learn a beautiful stitch. So let's start with the slip knot in chain 34. So we will make a slip knot in chain 34 into the fourth stitch from the hook. I will work a double crochet. Into every stitch I will work one double crochet. For a double crochet we will yarn over, go into the stitch, pull up a loop, pull it through two loops and pull it through two loops. So this is how I will complete all these stitches. Okay, so as you can see all my 31 crochets are completed and now I will show you how to make the design. So let's start by chaining one. Go into the same stitch and work a single crochet. Now make chain 4. Into this first chain from beginning I will work 2 double crochets. It's a little tricky but please pay attention to the instructions so you will surely learn it. Just make 2 double crochets into this first chain of chain 4. Now again make chain 4. Go into this first chain, work 2 double crochets. So this is how it will look, as you can see. Now skip 5 stitches. Go into the 6th one and work a single crochet. So this a butterfly kind of look it is. So again work chain 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Into this fourth stitch from the hook, I will work 2 double crochets, chain 4, into this first chain from beginning, I will work 2 double crochets, now skip 5 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, into this sixth one, I will work a single crochet. Again chain 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, into this first chain work 2 double crochets, chain 4, into this fourth chain work 2 double crochets, skip 5 stitches, in the sixth one work a single crochet. Okay, so I will repeat it till the end of this round and this is how it will look. All the stitches are completed. Now I will make chain 4 to begin the next round. As you can see that in this chain 3 of the previous row, the top one I will work 3 double crochets. Work 3 double crochets on the topmost chain of chain 3 of previous row. Go into the next space on the top of, as you can see, please identify that this was chain 3 and on the topmost chain of these chain 3 I will work 3 double crochets. So it will create a texture. I hope you will like it. Okay, just without making any chains, you will shift into the next and work 3 double crochets. Make sure that you will not work in double crochets, you will work in chain 3 and it should be the topmost. So work 3 double crochets each stitch. I hope you can understand it, but if you have any query please ask me in comment. So as you can see this is how it will look. My whole row is completed. The last stitch should be a double crochet. Now again repeat one, make chain 1 and single crochet in the first stitch. Chain 4, into the 4th chain from the hook I will work 2 double crochets, one and two, again chain 4, into 4th stitch, work 2 double crochets, okay, count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and into this 6th one, work a single crochet. So this is how the second row will begin. Again work the same way. This whole row we will work the same way by working chain 4. Into this 4th chain from the hook I will work 2 double crochets. Then work chain 4 again. Into this last chain work 2 double crochets. Skip 5 stitches. Work a single crochet. So this is how I will complete this whole row, and then I will make this one. So we will alternatively work like this, repeated row 2 and 3. Okay, so this row is also completed. The end stitch was a single crochet. Now I will make chain 4, turn into the top of 3 of the previous row, I will work 3 double crochets, shift on to the next and work 3 double crochets. So this is how I will complete the whole row. Don't forget to count the number of stitches at the end of every row, because it should not be increased. If you are not able to recognize the chain 3, so please and find it and then work, so that your number of count should be accurate. Okay, so this is how I will make this row end, and then I will make some few rows, and then I will show you how it looks after making few rows. So please stay tuned till the end of video. Okay, so this is how it will look after making few rows. So as you can see, this is looking beautiful, a very wide stitch and looking very beautiful, not so lacy and not so covered. So it's perfect for shawls also. So I hope you have liked it. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching. Thank you.